Having unsatisfied employees will ruin the workspace. Why not understand the workspace dynamics by building an employee survey? So let me show you how right now. Welcome to Job Form. My name is George, and on this video, I'm going to show you how to build an employee satisfaction form. Knowing what your employees are thinking about the workspace is crucial for any business. You need to understand what they like and what they don't like. That way you have a beautiful workspace where everything flows. You're going to boost morale, you're going to boost the engagement, and you're going to boost the production. So it's a win-win situation. And to know this, we are going to build a form that we can share easily with them via an email, scan with a QR code wherever they need to. And this data is going to be crucial for you to take decisions. And everything's going to be neatly stored here on JobForm database. So let's get started. This is my JobForm dashboard, and we are currently in the main workspace. We're going to view everything that we have available in JobForm, including applications, forms, AI agents, and all that will be available right here. What we want to do first is go to templates, because I want to show you that there's available templates that you can get started right now without having to build everything from scratch. So we're going to go down here, and there's several categories. In this case, we want to go to survey templates. We're going to find employee survey templates. We're going to select it. And as of this video, there's over 239 templates available that we can start using right away. Now, in this section, we're able to click on these templates and we're able to preview them and test them in case we want to use one of these. So we're able to fill it out without having the need to use this specific template. So we can see how it flows. And if we like this one, we can go ahead and use the template. But if we don't like it, we can test out other templates that might fit our needs. In this case, I'm going to use this one, which I do like because it has several questions available here that already fits my needs. That way I don't have to add every single one of these questions. So it helps me out to get started. So I'm going to use this template, and it's going to take me to the job form builder where I can modify every single aspect of this form. So in this case, if I click on the top section, I'll be able to change this logo by clicking on the properties icon. I can go ahead and remove this image and add a different one if I like. I can change the sizing, the alignment, and I can go to advanced options in case I want to use alternative text, a link to the image. So if they click on it, they go to the main website link, and it's up to you if you want to use all of this. So this is the file reference and the hover over text if I want to add that there. Okay, I want to change the title of this survey. So in this case, it's the employee motivation survey, and I'm just going to say Acme employee motivation survey. So it's just changing it, but it's super easy to do so. This way we can locate the form in case we have several forms available. Now, every single aspect of this form can be changed, including colors, elements. We can go ahead and add and remove if needed. In this case, it already has elements embedded into this form since we added a template. Now we can go ahead and keep these questions or remove them in case we don't need them. So in this case, for example, we have several questions available here, and I can go ahead and remove a question if I don't need it. So in this case, I'll click on the X button and I just remove that section of the question here. Now, if I want to add a brand new element because I think there's a question missing or a different style of question needed, maybe I don't want it to be anonymous. So what I want to do is ask for the name. So I'll click on add an element, and we have several elements available that we can start using. But in this case, I want to ask for the name, and I'm going to drag it inside of here, and I'll be able to modify this element that I just dragged in by clicking on the properties option. So in the options, I want to ask for the middle name too, in case they have a middle name. I can also add prefix, and I can add the suffix, and it's just super easy to modify the element that I've just dragged inside of here. Now on the left, we have several elements available, including the basic elements. We have the survey elements and dividers, sections, collapse, and page breaks. So in this case, maybe I want to add a star rating. So I'm going to drag it inside of here, and I'm going to ask, how would you rate HR? And that's just like a basic question, just kind of know how they are performing. And I'll go into the properties because I want to add more stars to this. So I don't want to keep it at 5 stars. I want to give them a better option to select. So in this case, I'm going to go to options. I'm going to go to the star rating amount, and I'm going to type in 10. So now this is a rating of 1 to 10 stars. In this case, it could be blue stars, hearts, light bulb, lightning bulbs, flags, etc. I'm going to keep stars for this case. And there's advanced options in case I need to shrink this to add another element inside of there, in case I want to keep the form a little bit more compact. There's also the scale rating, which is what we're viewing right here on the top. So this is scale rating, this is star rating, and on the bottom is the input table. So several options available for our employee satisfaction survey. Now there's several available elements that we can use here for questions like drop downs, single choices, multiple choices, what type of meals do they like, are you vegetarian, just kind of understand what they like and need so we can improve the workspace dynamics. There's also the payment elements. In this case, it wouldn't apply, but if you want to add a payment gateway, it is possible here in JotForm. And there's widgets too. So if you want to add a form calculator, a multiple text fields, maybe terms and conditions, a signature, take a photo, maybe you want to allow to upload files, that is possible with widgets and basic elements here on JotForm. Now, what about styling? Maybe I don't like the style that the template brought in. I can change everything right here. So I'll click on the form designer, and in form designer we got color scheme that we can change really easily by clicking on the color scheme. So if I don't like the style color that it came with, I just go ahead and click on this and it automatically changes the colors. In this case, I'll select that one. And if I want to customize every single color inside of here, I can go ahead and change the page color independently, the form color, and the font color really easily. There's also advanced designer options if you click on this button. You can also use style to change the form width, the label alignment, question spacing, label width, font sizing, and we have the custom CSS, which will let you highly customize the form to your style. There's themes available. If you want to select a pre-built theme that is really nice looking, go ahead and select it, and it's going to automatically update. There's also layout options if you want to switch from classic form to card form. So everything's going to be super easy to modify here on JotForm, including modifying elements, adding elements, removing elements, and changing the form style. We also have the setting options to set up the form settings, the emails, the notifications, the thank you page. If you want to have a thank you page or redirect them to another link, that is possible right here. Integrate to another application. So if you want to send that data via webhook, send it over to Google Sheets, Google Drive, etc., it is possible with integrations. You can start a workflow, use JotForm Design, or mobile notifications, all available right here. Now, if we go to publish, we can go ahead and share this with our employees via a link that is super easy to just copy and paste in an email or send it off wherever you need to, in a WhatsApp, Messenger, Slack, etc., or send it straight via email from here, add their emails and send it off. We can create an agent for this, and we also have options to share it via social media accounts, including QR codes. So if you want to have a QR code that we can print and have it ready for them to scan and fill out the employee satisfaction survey, it is possible right here really easily. And if you want to add this to our website, it is possible by going into the embed option. So if I want to embed this on a website, I just go ahead and grab this code and paste it in a website. I can do it via iframe, via WordPress, a feedback button, a pop-up, a lightbox, or a source code. Several available options to share this with your employees. You can also assign forms. You can also set up emails for reminders and instant sharing. You can share this via email or schedule a reminder email, pre-fill, PDF, and platform. So several available options for you to send it over to your employees so they can fill it out. And this way you can understand what they are thinking. Are they motivated? Are they satisfied? Or are they unsatisfied? Maybe they have other needs. Maybe they want to change something in the workspace to improve it. Well, it's good to know all of this. Now, once you get all that data, we're able to have that data stored neatly in JotForm tables. So let me go ahead and fill this out twice to show you where you're going to find those details. Okay, here we go. I just filled it out twice. Let me go ahead and jump out of preview. Let's click on the top menu here, and we're going to go to tables. In tables, we're going to view all these details that were filled out neatly stored in JotForm tables. So we're able to view every single aspect of the form that was filled out really easily here on the JotForm tables. So I have the date of the submission, the name of the person, how long do you work at Acme Company, how challenging, how focused you are, how would you rate HR, the type of questions. So if I want to view each one of the selections that they've selected, I'll be able to view everything right here really neatly stored. Now I can change the type of view in case I want to view it in a different way. So that helps me out preview this and view it more clearly by creating a new tab. So one of my favorite views for this purpose would be cards. I'll go ahead and select this, select the form. There we go. I'm going to select this form right now. So it's the Acme Employee Motivation Survey. And I'm going to drag in the elements that I want to view in the card. So I don't want to view every single piece of data, just certain data that is going to help me understand. So let's just say that I want to know how they rated HR and when it was submitted. So the submission date, name, and HR. I'll go ahead and create this, and I'll be able to view in a card style just that data. So it helps me view at a quick glance data that I think is important without having to view every single one of the questions that were typed or filled out here on this survey form. So this is a fantastic way to keep all the data stored. It helps me out use filters and find out what my employees are thinking. So don't forget to sign up right now here on JotForm. It's super easy to get started. And let me know what you think about these templates that we have available as of this video. So don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that little bell notification to get notified when new videos come out. And that's a wrap.